Right, we're at Draycott Sleights. I'm just going to check the time. My God. I don't know if that's a 6 or a 4. It could be 3 minutes past 3, which is very good. That's very good. That gives us 3 hours. But like I said, it had to be 4 o'clock when we got to the other side. So it could be that. That could be a 6, mind. It did look a bit dodgy between a 3 and a, you know. With my eyes being like they are. It's not too muddy today, that's good. Not too muddy. They're still going to be muddy in my shoes, but they won't be as bad as they were. A route down there you can take takes you down to Draycott, see? I haven't ever done it. Down through these beautiful avenue of trees, there are paths down, but I've not actually done them. I'll just do a little bit more videoing here. I just want to look at the clock again as well, a minute. I've got a feeling that is a 5 for 15, which means we're all right. We're all right, we don't have to panic. The 3 o'clock bus is just leaving Cheddar. Then you've got the 4 o'clock. You've got the 5 o'clock. And you've got the 6 o'clock. With me, I have to pace it. Oh, like I said, allow 2 hours. From the other side of Draycott Sleights. God, I really notice it when I got to start going uphill again. It's only a little hill. Some beautiful views here. Beautiful views. From this avenue of trees. You've got Brent Knoll out there, look. Contacts right over the back. Lovely views of Somerset. There could still be cows in this field I've got to go through. Most of the time I've ever gone through Draycott Sleights, there's been some sort of cow there. Sometimes they have these really big, hairy, woolly cows. I expect them to be seen in the winter. I said, I only videoed this December when I came up from Westbury Submendip I didn't do the Epic Gorge or the Wookiee Horse. Today I've done an extra chunk. Lovely trees there. All be in bloom soon. All be in bloom. My walks in the summer will be the Quantox, will be the Mendips, Roeburn, Warren. Those will be my summer walks. And I'll try and fit in a new one if I can. I'll try and fit in a new walk if it's possible. Draycott down there, and I was right up there earlier, wasn't I? Up somewhere. I've been up and down. These are the Sleights, and when you're right over on the Mendips, or further over that way, you can look over this way to the Sleights. They stick out. Right, here's a restored pan well, drinking hole. It's nice, isn't it? Up there we got the Sleights. And I'm going to follow this path I don't normally do. So I always think it takes me downhill. I've got enough hill walking to do as it is. Over there we got that Bridge and Cheddar Reservoir. Hills behind Mendips. When I get to the gate at the other end of the field where cows are sometimes, I'm gonna have a drink out the flask, and I'm gonna have an orange. Over there in the distance we can see the quarry that I bypassed. One of the quarries. I was right up the top walking up there the other week when I did the Winscombe to Cheddar walk, and I bypassed a couple quarries. I don't often walk down here, but you get another view, really, of the Sleights from down here. Draycott Village. I'm just beginning to feel a bit peckish now, so I'm looking forward to a drink of warm water, or hot water even, and something else to eat now. It's been a long time. I haven't had a lot to eat. I can just feel a glucose low coming on though. Yeah. I can just feel a glucose low coming. But I always sort of make rules for myself, like little targets. So I don't normally come down here. I would have been on a higher path. But I don't mind having a go on this one today. It enables me, like I say, to get some other shots of the Sleights, Draycott Sleights. That, I say, when you're right over there on the Mendips by Crook's Peak, you can look over and see these. They really stick out, like a big mountain. They really stick out. Right, going to turn off for a minute, take some more pictures.